Yeah, let's get an update on the leg hole.
The leg hole. Well, I actually went to the doctor today, and he said it's progressing nicely, but it's still like an inch deep in one spot.
Yeah, so tell people how they determine this. This is great.
It's very scientific.
Yeah.
It's very difficult. So what they do is they take, you know, one of those long Q-tips with the wooden handle? They take one of those and they take the end that doesn't have cotton on it and they poke it in your wound until it stops. They poke it with a stick and then they pull it out and they measure the blood.
It's a dipstick! They use a fucking dipstick!
They dipstick your wound to see how deep it is, and then they measure it.
Only it's blood!
They literally poke it with a stick to determine how deep it is. So I'm still doing my zombie apocalypse field dressing every day, or I have to stick a syringe in it full of sterile water and irrigate it and then pack a bunch of stuff in it and wrap it up. And
it's shit like this that makes The Walking Dead that much more scary, isn't it?
Yeah.
Because you realize if we were in a zombie apocalypse, this shit would be happening, only you wouldn't be having, you know, assistance from medical personnel.
Well, you know, it's funny. I was talking to Nella, who a lot of people know Nella, like a month ago, and I was lamenting that, like, I don't have any useful skills for an apocalyptic scenario. Like, I'm an artsy-fartsy person. I sell makeup for a living. Like, I am the first one to go down in that scenario because I'm a giant wuss and I have no useful skills. And in true be careful what you wish for style,
now you have some.
Now I can pack a festering inch-deep wound.
Well, you're one up on me. I have no useful skills for an apocalypse. So, all my possible skills revolve around electricity. And that's not going to be here when the zombies come. So I'm just going to be food.
So be careful what you wish for, kids, because you might get a hole in your leg.
Yeah, well, you know.
But yeah, I mean, the doctor's very happy with it.
Who wishes for a hole in the leg?
There, you know, I have this very funny doctor. I don't know what kind of accent he has, but he's really funny. He's like, oh, it looks wonderful. And I'm like, okay, clearly doesn't look wonderful. It's a hole in my leg. But I appreciate your optimism.
You have a weird definition of wonderful, and I don't want to see your browser history.
But he's a wound care specialist, so this is the same guy when I was in the hospital. He came in to see me just as they had served me my breakfast. And he said, oh, don't let me interrupt your breakfast. Keep eating, keep eating. And then opened up the thing and started. And I'm like, no, I'm good. But that's what he does. So he doesn't care. But so it's good. It doesn't really hurt. It itches like crazy.
That is good. Itching and, you know, means it's not going to be a hole for much longer.
Cute skirts are pretty much out of the question for the foreseeable future.
You can get around that. I told you, I gave you that scarf suggestion. That
I bought so many cute pairs of tights for fall.
Now you have a hole in your leg.
Now I have a hole in my leg. And like I can't wear my skinny jeans because they're too tight for the bandage. My whole fall wardrobe is blown, basically.
Priorities.
I kind of live in yoga pants right now. Because that's what I can wear.
Well, are we ready for... This week is amazing. There's quite literally a whole lot of white people this week.
Oh, good.
I think you know the story we're going to lead off on. Let's get the intro going. Each week, Catherine and the Radio Dead Air audience go out on the worldwide interwebs, find all sorts of horrible stuff, bring it back here. Except what we like to call, what the fuck is wrong with you? Now, currently, in around St. Louis County, Missouri, we're having problems. If you're not in America, you don't understand this. If you're in America, you think this is fine. Shit's fucked up. We're having these issues between, you know, the police and the community of Ferguson, Missouri, because they shot it, you know, a black teenager, and the community's mostly black.
Yeah.
It's a big fucking issue. So there have been protests.
It's horrible.
Protests.
It's still going on, and the media is bored with it, but
right, and the police have been shooting them with tear gas, and it's been awful. And, you know, that is...
And now that officer claimed the kid had a gun, but the kid pulled a gun on him.
Yeah.
When the one thing we have known all along is that kid was unarmed. From day one, we have known that kid had no gun. And now the officer's statement came out and said the kid pulled a gun on him.
So this is what it takes to get their community incensed. It's an injustice. So what do you think it takes to, say, get a white New Hampshire community to riot?
Dave Matthews Band?
Close!
I was at the Dave Matthews Band Riot concert in Connecticut in 1990-something.
This, and I swear to God, if this wasn't coming from The Guardian, I would call fake on this shit.
Oh no, it was all over yesterday.
But no. This
it took
is,
over Twitter.
This is...
Why are you doing that? Why are you not doing what I tell you to do?
I ask that of my computers every day. That's the wrong one. We'll get to that one. Arrest and tear gas as New Hampshire Pumpkin Festival descends into chaos. New Hampshire Pumpkin Festival descends into chaos. Violent disturbances near Keene State College during annual Pumpkin Festival lasted until early on Sunday and involved dozens of arrests and injuries as police in riot gear used tear gas to disperse crowds. A pumpkin festival! And they invoke tear gas! And when I say tear gas, I don't know if they're talking about cans getting thrown or if they have those fucking grenade launchers that look like gigantic revolvers.
Oh, I don't know. Happily, I've never been tear gas, so I don't know. But pumpkins. It was one of those blaze things where they had like thousands and thousands of pumpkins on display.
Yeah, it was just, you know, come see the pumpkins. Here's the biggest pumpkin. It'll get a ribbon. We've got pumpkin beer. We've got pumpkin lattes. White people!
White people heaven, which means riots.
But listen,
I mean, all you need is for the local sports team to win a championship, and you've got the perfect storm for a white people riot.
Listen to this. One
Because white people love turning over cars when our fucking sports team wins something.
When we win! Not when we lose!
Not when we lose.
When we win!
We go home and drink. When we win.
We fuck everything up. We live there is the thing.
Home. Yeah.
We live in the town, and we blow shit, we fuck shit up. Listen to this. One group of young people threatened to beat up an elderly man, and another resident heard someone threatening to kill officers. At a pumpkin festival!
I mean, obviously this is Starbucks' fault. They released the pumpkin spice latte early this year, and I think you have a limited incubation period on how much of the pumpkin spice white people can take. Before it becomes like Jekyll and Hyde type serum.
And you know, I said this on Twitter, but I stand by it. If we're gonna have a riot over a fruit, let's have a riot over coconut. Because it's not a nut. It's a liar.
But coconut oil is really good for your hair.
Yeah, but that's bullshit. It's a liar. I would flip some cars over that shit. Not pumpkins. Everybody love pumpkins.
There was actually a picture going around Twitter with like four dudes standing on top of an overturned car with flames in the background. And you're pumpkin. Like, is Dude. This... A throwback to the Rodney King riots? Is this... Oh, no, it's a pumpkin festival in New Hampshire.
New Hampshire Pumpkin Fest! This is like some Mad Max shit. This is pumpkin festivals of the future. The post-apocalyptic pumpkin festival.
Two white boys enter. One white boy. That's the natural progression. We'll have Pumpkin Thunderdome, where, like, frat dudes have to put a carved pumpkin on their head and fight to the death.
So, moving on, it's not just the false harvest season. It's also, of course, time to put out the Christmas decorations, even though it's October.
Obviously.
Well, Paris put out a rather interesting one that was made by American artist Paul McCarthy. This is supposed to be an artistic installation. It's a Christmas tree.
Yeah. It's festive.
Now, I want everyone to remember, what you're about to see is supposedly an art deco Christmas tree, or artistic installation Christmas tree. Yeah.
You didn't send me a link.
I'm sending it. Yeah.
I'm a little surprised this wasn't Jeffrey Koons, because this is totally a Jeffrey Koons thing to do.
That has got to go on the big screen, that everybody can see.
In its full majestic glory.
Because the first thing I think when I see that is not, oh, Christmas tree.
It's oh something.
Oh, yes. That's a butt plug. There's no beating around the bush, so to speak. That's a butt plug. That is a giant three-story. That's a three-story tall butt plug. Okay, in the channel, of course, we're getting ho ho ho. Green Giant.
That's what it should be called.
The Very Jolly Green Giant.
That's Galactus's butt plug.
There is no one in the world who would look. If you look on that and go, that's a Christmas tree. Oh, honey, no.
I mean, it is also.
Bullshit.
Clearly, people cut it down, you know.
We're getting to that, because when this was being designed, you know, there were 10 people who were part of this process who were going, Paul?
It was on purpose. Come on.
This was deliberate. There's no way he could not have known he was making the world's giant butt plug.
Which is why I say I was surprised when I read it and it wasn't Jeffrey Koons, because this is such a him thing to do.
But,
you know?
Yeah, but
especially now that he's hooked up with Lady Gaga, like.
But as you said, things got better. Because apparently even Paris, even permissive, liberal, sexually liberated Paris.
Topless beaches, Paris.
They could not abide the butt plug of Christmas. Because
maybe it should have been a giant baby Jesus butt plug. I mean, if you're going to do a Christmas butt plug, it should really be a baby Jesus butt plug. Because Jesus is the reason for the season.
Controversial artwork in the center of Paris is said to resemble a giant green sex toy was apparently vandalized overnight Friday after critics decried the 80-foot installation as a humiliation for the French capital. There's the sad butt plug.
Yeah.
It's
having some performance issues right now. It happens to a lot of Christmas trees. I mean, how many Christmas trees really stand up straight? Am I right? They all list a little bit. Some of them bend. You have to be accepting of these things. Not everybody gets a Christmas tree like in the movies where they're perfect and stand perfectly erect and are beautiful. Sometimes they're a little bit, you know, off.
Even Paris.
I could keep this going.
I know you could. Because penis. But, you know, even Paris could not abide this. Even Paris looked at this and went, no.
A little too far. I kind of want it. If I didn't live with my very preppy conservative sister, I would kind of want this for my front lawn.
You know the sad part, however, there is one. The saddest part about this, it didn't light up.
I know.
That would have been.
Because there's a whole
perfect
BuzzFeed article on how to use sex toys as ordinary household things, like. You use a one of those suction cup dildos as a toilet paper holder. You use the giant rubber vagina as a towel holder. Like, you shove the towel in it, you know. Like, it's like 21 ways to use sex toys just as household items. So, like, I want that house with this on the front lawn. And for everybody to just be like, don't even go over there, man.
Yeah, exactly. You're like, this is your way of saying no one visit me ever.
Like, so much more effective than a no solicitors sign.
True. A giant butt plug on the front lawn kind
of. The Jehovah's Witnesses? Never gonna bother.
Well, no, because they're not gonna know what it is.
They might.
If they do, they're. Let's go to that house! No, we're not going there. Why not? It's festive! Look, they have a giant tree! That's not a tree.
I just want a giant, like, totally benign sex dungeon of a house.
Our next one comes to us, I believe this is LA? Yeah, this is LA. You've been playing with OkCupid and the wonderful things that happen dating. The wonderful messages you get.
Such wonderful messages.
It's not a real place, at least in people's brains.
Somebody said I had sexy camel toe in my phoenix costume, and I'm like, sorry to burst a bubble, but that's a zipper.
We see what we wish to see in life.
Somebody sent me a very, very polite message. He's a submissive looking for a dominant woman, and all he wants to do is do my nails. And I was like, you're so sweet, but I don't even fucking let pros do my nails. Only I do these nails. But good luck.
Yeah, online, when you meet people online, it can go good. But a lot of the times, it's a scary, creepy kind. And one dude in LA discovered that. Woman arrested after becoming trapped in chimney at Thousand Oaks home. Woman is accused of illegally entering the Thousand Oaks home of a man she went on multiple dates with and was arrested Sunday after firefighters used jackhammers to partially dismantle a brick chimney she had become trapped inside.
Okay, you know what? This shit's getting old. It's not even Halloween yet. Stop with the Christmas shit. Next thing you know, Christmas is going to start right after back to school. You do not get to slide down your boyfriend's chimney in your fucking naughty Santa lingerie until it's December. That's just etiquette.
The County Fire Department's urban search and rescue team was called to the scene. Photos posted on Twitter by the department. That's bad when the fire department is taking pictures of your ass stuck in a chimney and putting it on Twitter. By the department showed firefighters on the roof of the house. They worked to reach the woman who was conscious during the rescue. The flue was lubricated with dish soap before she was lifted out of the chimney. The woman whose, quote, intent was unclear was known by the homeowner. She was later identified as Genoveva? Did I say that right? Yeah, Genoveva Nunez Figuera. I am so bad at names that are not like Smith and Jones. A 30-year-old Thousand Oaks resident and arrested for allegedly illegally entering a residence and providing false information to a peace officer. Holmes resident, who did not wish to be identified, I don't blame him, said he had met her online and had gone on about 6 dates. He cautioned other people about allowing acquaintances into their homes.
Alternately, this could be filming for season 3 of The Following gone horribly awry. But they've gotten away from the Edgar Allan Poe thing. So, probably not.
When you have to use the chimney to see your intended, honey, he's just not that into you.
Unless he leaves out cookies.
Well, that's some weird-ass role play there.
Hey, everybody got their something. I had a guy who wanted to do my nails.
Will you be my Santa?
Different strokes to rule the world, man.
Stuff my socking. Just, okay, the channel. Video is video. Chim-chiminy. Oh, shit. How? This is one of those things where he's not answering the door. He's not answering his phone. He's not talking to you. Chimney is not the obvious next step.
No.
That's not where this road leads.
I mean, everybody knows you show up at his job screaming about child support. Everybody knows that. That's the next step.
Chimneys further down the road.
Yes. It's like skipping the double dog dare. It just, it's not done. It's poor form. But there's a very specific set of steps in being a crazy ass clinger.
Somewhere in the world tonight, Phoebe Cates' ears are burning, and she doesn't know why. If you get that joke, you, sir, or madam, are a fine nerd.
Right.
Hopefully it'll come to you.
Something to do with gremlins?
Mm-hmm. You've seen gremlins, right?
I have. Well, kind of. I was afraid of it when we went to see it in the theater, so I heard gremlins. I mostly saw the sleeve of my aunt's sweater.
You've got... You have Netflix! I know you have Netflix!
I mostly use it to watch The Avengers, like, once a week.
Well, there are other things!
Yeah, but The Avengers is on there.
So
I have a queue of, like, 50 things. I go on Netflix, and I pretty much watch The Avengers.
So do you ever follow beauty contests?
Like pageants?
Yeah.
No, not really.
I've never really, the whole concept of it just sort of boggles, baffles
me. We used to watch the Miss America pageant when I was a kid, but.
See, I don't, well, and there are the things in Miss America. There's Miss Universe, there's state pageants, there's lots of different ones. This one, however, I don't think is going to catch on. Miss Hitler 2014 seeks the most anti-Semitic of them all. Nazi-inspired beauty pageant calls for contestants to submit selfies to pro-Hitler page on Russian equivalent of Facebook. Nazi-inspired beauty pageant dubbed Miss Hitler 2014 is calling for attractive women to participate in the contest held in the Russian equivalent of Facebook. Participants are requested to submit Nazi-themed selfies to the competition organized by a neo-Nazi group on Russia's largest social networking service, along with a caption describing why they, quote, love and revere the Third Reich and Adolf Hitler.
Oh.
You know, I'm a little curious about this one, because there's always that section of the beauty pageant where they ask him a question. The answers on this one would be just... Oh. Wow!
Yeah. How would you achieve world peace would be especially enlightening.
Well, we kind of know the answer to that one.
Wow. I mean, I'm sure there are some really, really good-looking neo-Nazis out there.
Oh my God, listen to this.
Does it come with a scholarship?
The requirements of the competition were reportedly listed as the following. 1, be a woman. 2, be a Nazi. 3, be a woman Nazi. A little redundant, but okay. 4, be a woman who hates the Jews. 5, be a member of the Adolf Hitler group. 6, post a sexy Nazi pic. 7, get other Nazis to like your pic. And 8 is the best one. Don't insult other women's pictures.
Yeah, don't be a hater.
Now, the good news is, and it was in another article, this got pulled the fuck down.
There is no room for hate and anti-Semitism, okay?
The people who run the social network, they yanked this the fuck down. Because they were like, no, we ain't gonna be part of this. And this is in Russia right now, where being gay is not something you want to be in Russia right now. They are not fucking around about, it's scary.
The Nazis, like, that's like a legit fetish, though. Like, that's a subculture. It's not even a niche fetish. You don't know this?
Yeah.
It's a big thing. Like, Nazism is... I shudder to use the word legit, but it is a not unpopular sexual fetish.
It's one of those weird things where it's like, you know, these people are walking around all day thinking, oh yeah, everybody agrees with me. They're like, oh, of course they must. They're sure that everyone really secretly agrees white people are the best thing ever. And you know, I'm a white person. Sometimes we really aren't all that great.
I think the first story of the night proved that.
Yeah. Because pumpkins!
We ride over pumpkins.
Pumpkins!
We are not the best thing ever.
We're heading back to LA again, funnily enough. So we've had this type of story before. But this one, I think, has got a little bit of a different twist on it. Because this kind of is like, really? You are an ungrateful fuck. Man steals LA Fire Department ambulance sent to help him.
Well, that's just counterproductive. Why would you do that?
Man being treated by paramedics stole a Los Angeles Fire Department ambulance and led police on a chase that ended in a traffic collision, sending two women to the hospital. Minor injuries. They're okay. Paramedics responded to a medical call. Then the man drove off in the ambulance. Paramedics were not in the ambulance at the time. Officers began a pursuit that ended when the ambulance crashed into a vehicle at the intersection of Beverly Boulevard. Two women in the car were taken to the hospital with minor injuries. The suspect, whose name was not released, was taken into custody at Rampart Station. Okay, this is not a do-it-yourself.
What were they treating him for? It doesn't say.
Apparently stupidity. Yeah, I love David's like, fuck it, I can get there faster.
This is like the laziest Grand Theft Auto ever. Like, you called takeout on a stolen vehicle. You don't get to do that.
Thieves these days, man. They aren't willing to work for that shit.
I know. You don't get to call takeout on fucking larceny.
When we were kids, they would work at this shit. You know?
Exactly. You would go and find a car and jimmy it open and hotwire it.
911, what is your emergency? I need a ride.
You know, we'll have that eventually, because we had someone call 911 because of chicken nuggets.
Yeah.
We had somebody call ahead to rob the bank. I'm going to be robbing the bank. Please have my money ready in an hour.
We are some lazy fuck.
Fucking Americans, man.
They don't ever say what he was being treated for, but I cannot imagine being in an ambulance and going, I've never driven one of these before.
Yeah, you can. Come on.
Yeah, it's me. It's me. First thing I'd be doing is figure out which button turned on the siren.
Yep. And how to work the defibrillator paddles.
Clear! I saw that on Arrow. You see that episode? Diggler kills a guy with the defibrillator paddles. And I knew it was coming. And then he goes, clear. And I'm like, I know you were going to fucking say that.
Dana Scully killed Cancer Man with defibrillator paddles, but she put them on his head. And I was never clear on why that worked, because he was made of cancer. He was able to grow a new head after his head had been cut off, but for some reason, defibrillator paddles to the forebrain was the secret. I never thought that really worked as an ending, but it was otherwise a really good episode.
Our final one tonight. Wow, this last one tonight. It is Walmart. It is Florida. And prepare to be sad. I mean, just really sad inside on a deep spiritual level.
I don't have a comfort hippo handy. I have a comfort cactus.
A long time
ago. It's just like a luchador.
In my first ever video, I said something that to this day remains one of the smartest things I have ever said. Nothing is hot in Walmart.
There is nothing sexy at the Walmart. It's true.
Nothing. Even, I've even said, even the lingerie section. Because it just feels weird, because they have the bright lights, and just, nothing is hot at the Walmart. Those halogen lights, nothing looks good under fluorescent lights, man. Nothing looks really sexy under fluorescent lights. I don't care what it is. Especially though, it looks like a warehouse with lingerie in it, and that's just got some creepy connotations.
Well, and the lingerie is like right next to Dora the Explorer coloring books.
Yeah!
And dog food.
Yeah, that'll fuck you up. Well,
it's where OkCupid got his shop.
So I don't know. I don't know. Man arrested for lewd act
with
Walmart stuffed animal. Florida man accused of getting amorous with toy on the store's beds. 19-year-old Florida man was arrested for getting amorous with a stuffed horse while shopping at Walmart.
That is some excellent euphemisming.
Getting amorous. Public clopping. Don't Google that. According to police, Sean Johnson, see, I can pronounce that one, was observed removing the stuffed animal from the shelf of the store in Brooksville, taking it to the store's bed, I know, and using it to masturbate. Here's the kicker.
Oh.
He then put the stained animal back on the shelf and exited the store.
That's not what it means when they say they're going to send a horse to the glue factory. That's not what that means.
Jesus, Tara. Jesus.
I'm not even sorry.
To put it back on the shelf.
I know. All sticky and gross.
A little girl is good. Who love horses. Little girls love horses.
Mommy, it's a pony.
Can I have the pony? And they just want to hug the pony. And that.
No, the pony has hepatitis.
Walmart merchandise came into contact with the stuffed horse was deemed contaminated. So not just the horse. Anything that thing touched. They had a bonfire out back behind Walmart.
Because now that is technically a biohazard.
A biohazard!
Bodily fluids people do not fuck around with now. I was on a contact restriction when I was in the hospital because I had secret MRSA. So like anything that I might have drooled on was like...
This asshole was pissing me off so much because it's a toy horse. If you must, if you have to, if you really cannot get your jollies any other way than mounting a horse a weird way, buy it and take it home!
Because it's Walmart. That thing couldn't have been more than $10.
Take it home!
And here's the thing, like... I don't fucking care what you do in your own house.
Right, exactly.
Fuck all the stuffed animals you want in your own
exactly.
house.
Exactly.
We've done stories about people that fuck balloons. Mm-hmm. We had that magical video of that like 80-year-old guy
you
just popping balloons in his thighs.
You were never going to let that go. You were never going to let that one go.
It was amazing. Like, whatever you want to do in the comfort of your own home with other consenting, exactly. cognizant beings, cool. I'm not fucking here to judge you.
But not in the store with something that doesn't belong to you. And
yes. It happened. Like, when I was a kid, like if I asked my mom for a candy bar at the store, I'd start to open it and she was like, no, it's not yours yet. Like she was not one of those moms that would hand on the wrapper and pay
right.
for it. Like, no,
right.
it's not yours yet. And then after they'd scan it, she'd go, okay, now you can eat it. Like now it's ours.
Also,
yours? Not yours. Important distinction when you're fucking something.
Also, it says he was observed removing it, using it, and then putting it back on the shelf. That means someone watched this entire debacle go down. and did not attempt to intervene.
Would you? Hell no.
Depends on what you mean.
Well, I've worked a lot of motherfucking retail in my life. I ain't going anywhere near that shit.
It depends on what you mean by intervene. Because there would be going near and going, hey, or there would be going and getting the nearest fire extinguisher and just hosing the fucker down. Like a cat who's like, you know, fucking pissed on the bed, squirt bottle. I get a fire suit. No! No!
When I worked at Spencer's, we had the Japanese restaurant in the mall. The owners had a kid. He was kind of mentally challenged. They just let him wander the mall all day while they ran the restaurant. And he would periodically come in and enjoy himself to some of the products in the store. The fuck was I going to do about it? Like, the kids... I'm not going to harass a special needs kid. I'm not going to get involved. Like...
This is just...
You kind of just have to let it play out and deal with the aftermath sometimes.
Oh, could you just imagine there'd be like a slowly expanding circle in the store? Like a radius of people just moving back? It would just be like a radiating outward to the point where the people are backed against the walls around the
quarantine zone.
People are like up against the walls at all sides of the Walmart. They're not entirely sure why, but they don't want to, you know, just...
It's like the Gravitron ride.
What are we doing? Just get back, man. Trust me.
Don't worry about it.
You'll thank me later. You will thank me later.
I'm just saying... Walmart almost certainly does not pay their employees enough to intervene on that shit.
Yeah, that's true.
Hell no. I'd be like, you know what? You pay me fucking $9 an hour.
I have $9 an hour. I have to buy my own fucking vest and pants and shirt from your store. I don't have dental. I don't have health care. You fucking go deal with the horse fucker. Ain't my problem.
Exactly.
He's not my problem. So I guess the first...
That is definitely above your pay grade.
First thing we learned this week, you could do it at home. Pay. Earn. Really? I mean, because it could not have been that expensive.
Fuck it's all Walmart. The plush horses you want at home.
Right.
Fuck a whole herd of plush horses at home. Go to town.
Why did it have to be...
Well, don't go to town. Go home.
Yeah, why did it have to be in the store? Who could even... You have to be somewhat superhuman to even potentially maintain an erection anywhere in the vicinity of a Walmart.
It's kind of like a building made of saltpeter.
That is like 10 Viagra tabs and like and a cock ring for good measure, okay?
And I don't think they sell either of those things at Walmart.
They do not.
It's immoral, and they don't have room because they stock the guns.
Even though they do sell personal massagers. We learned tonight that an ambulance is not a delivery.
No.
If you need a ride, it's called a taxi. And even in that instance, it's not self-service.
No. For that, you need Zipcar. I don't know if you have Zipcar where you are.
I'm aware of it. Just never use a black light in a Zipcar. It's all I'm saying. Never use a black light in a Zipcar.
Never use a black light in a fucking taxi on the subway. Just don't use a black light in public.
We've learned that even Nazis, sometimes don't be a hater. Because
God, you know, don't you want to know what the talent contest would be like on that thing?
I hope to Christ nobody brings out an easy bake oven. Oh, I'm going to get letters on that one. I'm going to get letters.
I think I just got absolved for the glue factory thing.
Yay!
I'm off the fucking hook.
Oh my God. Oh God. What happened? What happened? Something happened in the channel.
We learned that there's a mix on pumpkin spice. that there's a point at which the pumpkin spice turns bad.
Yes.
It's like the packs.
Also,
it'll placate 90% of the population.
But that 1%
of the population will go insane from the pumpkin spice. We have pumpkin spice fucking reavers. That's where we're at. That's where we're at, white people.
White people! We learned this week that...
Cutting on another man's pumpkin? Where does that get fun?
We learned this week that if you find yourself in a chimney attempting to woo your beau, reassess this relationship. You know, and finally,
either you're a creepy stalker or he's a big Edgar Allan Poe fan, and neither of those has a happy ending.
Nope. And finally, we learned that even Paris will not abide a giant butt plug.
But it's art. Art, damn it.
Yeah, you know the next thing coming in is a giant inflatable Santa positioned precariously over the top of it.
You know, Paris should just have a drink, little social lubricant, relax, take a deep breath, loosen up, and accept the butt plug.
Now I can never go to Paris.